Researchers used AI to generate images. Then, they could leverage it to take an image and edit it following a specific style, like changing it into a cartoon character or transforming any face into a smiling face. But this needed a lot of tweaking and model engineering and many trials and errors before achieving something realistic. There have been many advances in this field, mainly StyleGAN, which has the incredible ability to generate realistic images in pretty much any domain, real-life humans, cartoons, sketches, etc. StyleGAN is amazing, but it still needs quite a lot of work to make the results look as intended, which is why so many people are trying to understand how these images are made, and especially how to control them. This is extremely complicated, as the representation in which we edit the images is not human-friendly. Instead of being regular images of three dimensions, red, green, blue, it's extremely dense in information and therefore contains hundreds of dimensions with information about all the features the image may contain. This is why understanding and localizing the features we want to change to generate a new version of the image requires so much work. The keywords here are of the same image. The challenge is to edit only the wanted parts and keep everything else the same. If we change the colors of the eyes, we want all other facial features to stay the same. I recently covered various techniques where researchers tried to make this control much easier for the user by using only a few image examples or quick sketches of what we want to achieve. Now, you can do that using only text. In this new paper, Orr, Potashnik et al. Created a model able to control the image generation process through simple text input. You can send it pretty much any face transformation, and using StyleGAN and CLIP, it will understand what you want and change it. Then, you can tweak some parameters to have the best results possible, and it takes less than a second. I mentioned StyleGAN. StyleGAN is NVIDIA's state-of-the-art GAN architecture for image synthesis or image generation. I made a lot of videos covering it in various applications that you should definitely watch if you are not familiar with it. Before entering in the details, the only thing left to cover is the other model I talked about that StyleGAN is combined with, which is CLIP. Quickly, CLIP is a powerful language-to-image model recently published by OpenAI. As we will see, this model is the one in charge of controlling the modifications to the image using only our image and text as input. It was trained on a lot of image pairs from the web and can basically understand what appears in an image. Since CLIP was trained on such image text pairs, it can efficiently match a text description to an existing image. Thus, we can use this same principle in our current model to orient the StyleGAN generated image to the desired text transformation. You should read OpenAI's distilled article if you'd like to learn more about CLIP. It's linked in the description below. It has been used to search specific images on Unsplash from text input and other very cool applications. It will soon become very clear how CLIP can be useful in this case. By the way, if you find this interesting, please take a second to share the fun and send this video to a friend. It helps a lot. As I said, the researchers used both these already trained networks, StyleGAN and CLIP, to make this happen. Here's how. It takes an input image, such as a human face in this case. But it can also take a horse, a cat, a car, anything that you can find a StyleGAN model trained on such images with sufficient data. Then, this image is encoded into a latent code using an encoder, just like this, here called W. This latent code is just a condensed representation of the image produced by a convolutional neural network. It contains the most useful information about the image which have been identified during the training of the model. If this is already too complicated, I'd strongly recommend pausing the video and watch the short 1-minute video I made covering GANs where I explain how the encoder part typically works. This latent code, or new image representation, is then sent into three mapper networks that are trained to manipulate the desired attributes of the image while preserving the other features. Each of these networks is in charge of learning how to map a specific level of detail, from coarse to fine, which is decided when extracting the information from the encoder at different depths in the network, as I explained in my GAN video. This way, they can manipulate general or fine features individually. This is where the CLIP model is used to manipulate these mappings. Because of the training, these mappings will learn to move accordingly to the text input as the CLIP model understands the content of the images and encode the text in the same way as the image is encoded. Thus, CLIP can understand the translation made from a text to another, like a neutral face to a surprised face, and tell the mapping networks how to apply the same transformation to the image mappings. This transformation is the delta vector here that is controlled by CLIP and applies these same relative translations and rotations to the latent code W as what happened for the text. Then, this modified latent code is sent in the StyleGAN generator to create our transformed image. In summary, the CLIP model understands the changes happening in a sentence, like a neutral face to a surprise face, and they apply the same transformation to the encoded representation of the image. This new transformed latent code is then sent to the StyleGAN generator to generate the new image. And voilà! This is how you can send an image and change it based on a simple sentence with this new model. They also made a Google Collab and a local GUI to test it yourself with any image and play with it easily using sliders to control the modifications intuitively. Of course, the code is also available on GitHub as well. If you found this interesting, please give this video a like, comment on what you think about this research, and share it with a friend. It helps a lot. The only limitation for this is that you have to train the mapping networks, but they also attack this issue in their paper. For a deeper understanding of how it works and to see these two other techniques they introduced to control image generation with CLIP without any training needed, I'd strongly recommend reading their paper. It is worth the time. All the links are in the description below. Thank you for watching.